Today, I want to tell you about a feature of 3D models in PowerPoint 365 that very few people actually play around with, and that is the viewing window and positions of the camera, which can help you create some very cool fly-in and zooming effects with your 3D models. So let's dive in and take a look at these in more detail. First, let's start with the basic settings, which are the model rotation options here. If you have a 3D model like a car, for example, you can rotate it along its x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis using just the settings here. Now, these advanced camera settings is where it gets a little trickier. Every 3D model has this bounding box or viewing window around it, which is where we'll be playing with our camera settings. Let's start with camera position. This allows you to move the camera and its viewing window, sort of like a dolly, along the x-axis, y-axis, or get closer to the model on the z-axis. And let's get really close on the Z to fly into the castle. And now we can examine the lookout point, which lets you keep your camera position steady, but pivot to look over to the side, or up and down. Finally, a bit of a tricky one is the field of view angle. This refers to how much of your 3D model is shown in the viewing window. The bigger or wider the field of view is, the more of the model you see and the more of a fisheye effect you actually have. So here's an example of going from 30 degrees to 90 degrees with the same camera position and lookout point. Let's try that one more time. So those are your advanced camera settings, and honestly, you just have to play around with combinations of all of them, especially that Z-axis for model position, to get to the view that you're going for. And when you want to zoom and pan between views, you just put the same model on different slides and put a morph transition in between to get that smooth zooming and panning effect between the different views that you're creating. That's exactly what I did with this castle here to get all of the different angles. And if you want to make the model go full screen, you just have to stretch the viewing window to be the full size of the slide. This knight, by the way, was not included in the original castle. I actually put it into the castle myself in Paint 3D by aligning them together, kind of like this, and then saving as a 3D object, and then inserting into PowerPoint. If you want to get this combined model as a starter, just use the free download link below. Great, well that pretty much covers it. Definitely play around with these settings if you can, and you'll unlock a whole new way of looking at your 3D models. Thanks again for watching. Please comment, like, and subscribe for more videos, and keep it spicy till the next one.